Hello students, today we will do different embroidery stitches, basic embroidery stitches which we will cover. So we will start with the running stitch. First I had taken this fabric on which I had fitted this embroidery loop, and I put the thread in the needle, this anchor thread, and now I am going to start my first stitch. My first stitch which I am going to share with you is running stitch. For that I had put the needle through the fabric, I've taken it out, and now I will stitch it with the back stitch. By making 2-3 loops, I will make it sure that it will fit on the in the fabric. I will not make a knot. By this method, I had fitted the thread on the fabric. Now I am going to start the running stitch. For making the running stitch, we have to make it sure that the size of the stitch will be equal when it is made. Like, first we will go down, then we will come up, then we will go down, then we will come up. So the stitch size for the up stitch and down stitch should be same. It should be even. You can see it, how evenly it is made. Now I will end up it here by making the locking by using the back stitch. With same method I will stitch it, lock it here by using the back stitch. Now it is locked. I will cut the extra thread with a scissors from the back side. See, from the back side it is also seen visible. Same as it on the front. You can see to it clearly how neat it is from the front and the back also. For the next stitch we will do back stitch. Same, we will lock the thread in the fabric with the help of needle by using the back stitch. By making 2-3 loops here, I will lock my thread here to start up the stitch. Now I can see now my thread is locked here. So now I will move to make my back stitch. For the back stitch, what we will do, I will take the first stitch and take out here, and then I will go back. For the back stitch, we have to make the back stitches. First in front and then at back. There is no place between stitches, no spaces between there. This stitch is also used for making the outlines. When we finish an outline of the motif, we will use these stitches, like running stitch, like back stitch. We can use all these. Now I will end it up here by locking my thread on the fabric with the help of needle by using the back stitch again. By making 2-3 loops at the end, I will lock the thread here. Same way as we did before. Now it is locked, you can see to it. I will cut out the extra thread with the help of needle. From the starting also I had cut it. Now you can see how it looks at back and how it looks at front. Look how neat it is. Now the next stitch which we will make, it will be stem stitch. So now in the second part we will start with the stem stitch. For the stem stitch, what I had done, I had locked my thread onto the fabric. Look, it's locked now. So I will start with the stem stitch. For making the stem stitch, what I will do, I will take a stitch like this, make it, look, stem stitch. Now we will start up with the chain stitch. Look here, I have locked this thread on the fabric. Now I am going to start with chain stitch. Here I am taking the thread inside the fabric and the thread which is up above, putting down towards the needle for making a chain. Again and again I will repeat the same, putting the needle down from the fabric and putting the thread down from the needle like this, and I will put the thread up. Again and again I will make the same method to make the chain stitch. Chain stitch can be used for making outlining as well as filling for purposes. Here I am going to lock my thread as I have completed my line. So I will lock the thread by using the back stitch. Like this here. Thank you.
Next stitch what we will do buttonhole stitch. For the buttonhole stitch, I will lock the my thread onto my fabric, and now I am going to make buttonhole stitch. For buttonhole stitch, I will put my needle from here, take it out from this side, and my thread will go beyond my needle like this. And I will pull my thread out. It will look like this. Like this, I will make again, repeat the process again to make the buttonhole stitch. Buttonhole stitch can be used for making buttonholes in the garments by manual method, or buttonhole is also known as blanket stitch. Buttonhole stitch can be used for decorative purposes, for the decoration or surface ornamentation, or it can be used for gathering different layers of fabrics on the corners. Now I will lock the thread. From this, I will put the thread outside and lock it here. Here I will make back stitch 2 or 3 times so that I will lock the thread in the fabric. Like this. Friends, we will do feather stitch. For the feather stitch, I locked my thread on the fabric and I am going to do feather stitch. For feather stitch, we will make diagonal line first. And from here, I will take out the thread like this. In this way, I will make feather stitch. It is somewhat like cross stitch, but different from the cross stitch. It is used for making outlines. Now I will lock my thread here like this in the diagonal direction so that the loop will not appear. By using the back stitch, I lock my thread. Next stitch which we will do is open chain stitch. For open chain stitch, I lock my thread onto the fabric and I will make it like this. I will put the needle from the fabric like this. Sorry. I will go it like this, like chain stitch we were making. This was our chain stitch, but for the open chain we will make it like from here, like there will be difference like this. This is our open chain stitch. I will make it in different directions so that it looks a, it gives a nice look. Or I can make it in a straight way like this, one on the other. This is the way we make open chain stitch. I will lock my fabric thread here. Now we will make the cross stitch. You can see now I have locked my thread onto the fabric with the help of needle. Now I am going to start with the cross stitch. For the cross stitch, we will make diagonal lines for crosses like this. Once diagonal lines will be made, and then we will end up with the crosses, diagonal lines from the opposite sides.
for making this type of cross stitch, we can use different contrasting colors also. By making diagonal lines first with one color and then with the another color. Now I will make the process now. I will complete it up like this. By putting the diagonal lines from the opposite sides. With this method you can make the cross stitch. From the same holes, you can pass the needle. Here we will complete up our line. Thank you. That's all for today. We'll lock up our threads here. That is the final thing. Thank you.